So my task is a little bit difficult because I saw that today we discuss more about the achievement of academic institution and some problems which are connected to his copy of IBM machine. And I am also from the other side because I work all the time in Academy of Science, and my boss, Blagoev Sendov, probably will be a little bit angry of me because I will defend also the other part of the situation, the production of so-called RIAT or machine from unified system. Of course, I think that we should look very attentively to development of this both direction. The research in different institutions in Academy of Sciences of all countries, and of course the other direction when the government decided to unify the effort of a so-called socialist country at that time. It was established a commission in 1969, so-called International Council for Computer System. And this commission decided the development of computer system in socialist country. The commission consists of ministers from all these countries at that time. In the beginning, this is Bulgaria, Poland, Soviet Union, Czechoslovakia, Hungary, DDR, and in 1993, in this commission, joined also Romania, Cuba, Vietnam, and Albania's associated member. Here I mention what Vladimir told before. I put this slide because there is a lot of other Russian computers which you can see here. Ural, Setun, Razdan, Nairi, etc., Kiev, very interesting machine, but it is another topic. And here I also mention the machine Cifa 1, Cifa 2. I think that there is a Cifa 3 and 4 in Romania, but we discuss this later. At that time in Bulgaria, we started with first computer, Vitusha computer, which is on vacuum tubes. And of course, after that, we are going very fast with calculator, the first Bulgarian electronic calculator. I can say that at that time, we have only three calculators in the world. One from Italy, IME, the other Freedom, and one England, Anita. The Bulgarian is first, but with a lot of difference because he was fully electronic calculator. And after that, in 70, we shall see, we built the first calculator on integrated circuit. So, something about Vitusha. Basic parameter, about 1050 vacuum tubes, word 40 bits, index register, which we think that it is an innovative achievement, implement from Blagovest. Of course, we don't look around the other computer which exists at that time and maybe which were with big performance than Vitusha, but this is a first one with very good parameters. We built this computer in collaboration with Victor Toma, our Romanian friends, who at that time worked in Institute of Atomic Energy in Bucharest. Output is just IBM machine, typewriter, which we use to we use as a output. Here is a photo of the first Bulgarian computer. This is a Trier latch with the electronic tube. You can see this first module. We have 20, we have 200 such kind of module. Here we have two latches on this module. And you see this is the same. You can see Victor Thoma at that time. We put in operation the Vitusha machine in Moscow. So here Victor Thoma is photo with me and Georgi Lipiev in Moscow when he look at our working machine. Here is also interesting photo at that time, Blagoves Sendov. This is Tereshkova, first cosmonaut. This is Vaya, the wife of Gagarin, and this is me. First calculator Elka, 66, with printing devices. Next, we started to build a lot of plant, and here we have several big plant, which are for main computer, mini computer, electronic cash register, disk drive, magnetic tape, mechanical constructor, and so on. We have more than 30 big plant which started to produce devices and mainframe for RIAT series. Here is one of the plant in Bulgaria and who produce 1020. And near this plant is Central Institute of Computer Technique, which is more than, in 90, it is more than 3,000 people. Two words about the so-called RIAT. This is, of course, not all the machine, but you can see that unified system consists models 1010. This model was produced from Hungary. 1020, this machine was produced from Bulgaria and Soviet Union, especially the plants in Minsk and in Brest. 1021 is produced in Czechoslovakia. 1030 is produced in Poland and in Erevan and Kazan. 1040 is producing in DDR and Soviet Union part of them. And this 1050 and 1060 are Soviet Union produce this machine. You can see the devices, mainframe, channels, external storage, peripheral device, and devices for time sharing, operating system, special operating system for Hungarian 1010, and the other use in the beginning DOS and after that OS. But this is the first model. After that we have a lot of modification, 1020, 1022, 1035, 1037, also the other machine. I have no time to mention all of them. Here we have different also machines which are IBM compatible. We can discuss this if we copy IBM. I think that to copy it is very, very difficult task. So I prefer to say that we built analog to the IBM machine, because there is not possible to to copy all integrated circuit. The devices are distributed between all the country. For example, integrated circuits are produced in Hungary and Czechoslovakia. Magnetic disc and magnetic tape were produced in Bulgaria. Printer and are produced in Poland and DDR. TV were produced in Hungary and so on. So we have fully cooperation system, and it is not possible to copy one-to-one the devices and mainframe. So our institute make a lot of effort to make this system functionality compatible. And here is some of the parameters. AT, this is 1035 IBM 37 compatible ARRI processor. After that we have a high performance processor, computer system with CPU about 1.8 MIPS. And I will comment a little bit later, this is an advanced parallel system, which is built on the base of transputers and was original construction of Bulgarian Academy of Science. So in late 80, our academy established so-called Coordination Center for Information Technology and started to develop own production. And we have some really successful devices. One of them in Bulgaria is this. And this advanced system have performance 15 megaflops. At that time, it is very, very good performance. We export several such kind of system in Russia for diagnostic in Kurchatov Institute, diagnostic of atomic reactor, and we started to try to make a stimulator for the pilot of Sovalka with Logino Lodginsky, but the democracy came and everything was closed. But in any case, with this 1037, in the Institute of Institute for Cosmic Investigation in Moscow, they manage the Vega station when they work in Cosmos. This is mainframe 1020 with parameters. You can see this is a control panel of 1020 computer, 1971. The machine is built together with Minsk Institute for Computer System with several well-known specialists. This is Lopatov, Przelkovsky, Maltsev, Fyorov, Arcaturov, Pichtin, Smirnov, and so on. Maybe Vladimir knows some of them, Nemenman, Margolin. And of course, we have at that time very narrow collection with the institute in Kyiv, with which we produce mini computers, and Voronezh, where they also make some mini computers at that time. This is a mainframe computer. You can see here also from 1020 some of the circuit board. It is marked in this site. And this is one of the first Helkas still in operation, 40 years. It's okay, working. 1020 tape subsystem, 20 control system for disk. This is punch card reader. Punch card reader are produced, I think, in Poland. Here is a tape reader also produced in Poland or in DDR. This is also punch card output devices. You see that they are quite big. This is a printer line, also Poland production. And this is a console, Bulgarian production. This is a machine 1037, which is with 7 TRI processor with a relatively big performance. What I want to this is a parallel workstation based on 48 transputer FinMOS with own software system and with own application program developed in the Coordination Center for Information Technology. At that time with director Blagoves Sendov. At that time I was both involved in Academy of Science and I am director of Institute for Microprocessor Technique and in the same time chief constructor for personal computer from Bulgaria. This is a basic model of APS 1989. And we started to develop also the controller using transputers and also accelerator for personal computers. When you put such kind of accelerator in personal computers, you increase the performance more than 10 times. This is the first Bulgarian computer, which very similar to Apple. And after this first computer, we started to follow IBM series. Pravets, the name of IBM series compatible, was produced in our plant in Pravets. And the production we expect the production to be very, very, very high. The plant in Pravets was estimated to produce 100,000 computers per year. 100,000 per year. And here we have a modification based on Intel, but in the same time, we started to produce Intel in Bulgarian plants, in Bulgarian Institute for Microelectronics. And also I think that in Voronezh they have very good prototypes of Intel. This is Pravets 16, and this is mini and micro computer production. You can see, this is picture for microcomputers, and this is disk drive production, different kind. Practically, the Bulgaria was monopolist in production of disk drive, and we export a lot of them. This is a factory, disk drive factory in Stara Zagora, very big plant with a lot of people, about 5,000 people. This is a hard disk drive. First, several types of hard disk till 360 megabyte, 100 megabyte, 200 megabyte, and so on. This is magnetic tape. And very important picture, the organization of government of, I am finishing, of of United System, чиф конструктор, Крутовски, Ларионов, Призелковски, чиф конструктор from every country, and after that Council of Specialists. Very, very interesting organization. Here is some data about the production in Bulgaria, but here is interesting that total production is, you can see, very high, about per year, about $5 billion. And here is export. Bulgaria keep about 40% of export of all socialist countries as export. And main, this is due to the export of disk drive and magnetic tape. So as Vasily mentioned, from all this cooperation, Bulgaria have a lot of profit, but this is, you see, we export more than 44,000 disk drive for mainframe and 125,000 disk drive for mini computer. So this is a huge, huge production. And here you can see the, according to the AE2 market, the exactly how the information technology export is going. I want to mention also two words, because we are here in John von Neumann Society, but in Bulgaria we have also John Atanasov Society. John Atanasov is one of inventor of the first electronic computers. Personal data you can find. And of course, this is a complete replica of first ABC computer, which is now in the Historical Museum in United States. Thank you for attention.